Let's talk about the best format for keyword golden ratio terms. They're a little hard to find when you're first starting out, and let's face it, it's a little confusing. I mean, you're using a formula, you're doing an advanced Google search command that you probably never heard of, and it's new for most people. So finding KGR terms faster is one of the most common questions I get. And if you start trying to find keywords that fit the ratio and well, let's face it, you're going to get stuck. And this is normal. It's a little frustrating, but I'm going to show you a few things that are going to help you out. So, people want to know how to find keywords that are specific for their niche. It took me several months to hone in on this approach and then refine the process, but it works pretty well. And if you use these couple formats I'm going to show you, it makes it much, much easier. I find that once you put in the time, you will develop a skill in finding KGR terms. So once you start looking, you'll be able to find more and more terms and faster. And you can start with a few seed keyword terms and then dive deeper into a specific niche. I'll give you a couple common formats that I see that work out really well in terms of ranking quickly and finding them easily. So let's go on the machine here and start playing around. You'll be able to see my thought process here, which is scary. The idea here is if you know the formats that work really well for the keyword golden ratio, then it'll be easier for you to find keywords in whatever your niche is. And by the way, people ask often, does the KGR work only for affiliate sites? Does it only work for niche sites? And the fact is, it works for any kind of keyword research. You're literally looking at the supply and demand of the keywords out there on the internet. So it doesn't matter if someone is looking to buy a product, if you have an affiliate site, or if you have a niche site, or if you have a news site, anything where you're looking for organic search traffic, the keyword golden ratio, it's going to apply. It's going to work out okay for you. So there are two main types of keywords that we're going to look at, and I'm going to show you an example probably in the affiliate marketing world. So first kind of keyword we're going to look at is a buyer's type keyword. So someone is searching on the web for product information. They're doing research. They are probably going to make a purchase in the near future. It could be a few minutes, they're going to buy something really soon, or it could be a few days. It could be a few weeks, depending on the product type and the person and how urgently they need the product. So these buyers type keywords are really good for affiliate sites because usually you can earn an affiliate commission if you actually can provide someone with some information. And the second kind of keyword we're going to look at is informational, and informational keywords can be on any type of website, whether it's Wikipedia or if it's on an affiliate site or a news site or whatever you're trying to do. In fact, you can use some of these ideas for other types of content. So even if you don't have a website, you could use these ideas for YouTube keyword research. So keep that in mind. This is kind of a universally applicable kind of idea. So the thing we're looking at is buyer's keywords right now. So the best format for that is best and then the product type. So we'll look at specific examples, but I want to explain the concepts here. So best product type is very good. However, that's quite broad. It does indicate someone wants to purchase something, but usually it's fairly competitive and not very specific. And nowadays, people are very good at searching on Google for exactly what they're looking for. So, two pieces that you should put into your long tail keywords and your KGR keywords are the application and maybe the user type or demographic. So, what do I mean exactly? Basically, when we dive into a specific example, it'll be very clear. So, I'm going to use running shoes as the example here, and I'm just going to go ahead and change over to share my screen here so I could show you exactly what I mean here. So, we can. I just bought some shoes recently, so you could type in best running shoes and then you end up with, something fairly broad. However, when you look a little deeper, you see for women, all right, and for men. So what you could do is check out this format. So best product type for a specific user type. So we have women, we have men, we have flat feet, high arches. So those are specific types of people. It's very powerful when you look at these specific details. There's even words in here that you may not even know, like over pronation, supination. I don't even know how to pronounce it, and I know that word. I've read it before. And what you find is there's a lot more keywords out there when you look at the specific application or demographic. So to change it up a little bit, so these are mostly the user or the person has some sort of a symptom like plantar fasciitis or flat feet or high arches or whatever. So all those are great, but you also can look for the specific application. So maybe for 10Ks or 5Ks or maybe ultra marathons or ultra runners. So there's all these different classifications that you can use. And by the way, when you start looking at this, autocomplete is a great tool because it tells you other frequently searched for phrases in this same genre and in this same area. So we have best trail running shoes for ultra marathons and best minimalist running shoes for ultra marathons. And I bet if we put in best minimalist shoes for, then we have all these other applications and user types again. So we have beginners, we have wide feet, flat feet, treadmills, whatever. So this is a great way to find it. Now, you may be thinking, hey, maybe it works for running shoes, but what about something different? So maybe we'll look at some other product. I'm into camera gear and stuff like that. So maybe let's check out like best mirrorless camera. So again, pretty broad term, but once you put in four, you will see many different applications. So we have beginners, mirrorless cameras for video, we have travel, photography, streaming, so all over the place. And again, we can probably change this up a little bit. So we have mirrorless cameras for night photography. So what about beginners? Let's see if there's some other specifics that we can look at here. So under a specific price range, which is pretty cool. So you know that most of these cameras are going to be pretty close to $1,000. That's just the way it works. So you can take out the mirrorless part and then see, you know, people are searching for DSLRs as well. So we have beginners. What if we put in advanced? For advanced beginners, which is a little bit of a oxymoron there, but you can see that you can make this very specific. So Canon cameras, you can look at Nikon or other camera brands. So once you start looking, you'll find all these different combinations and permutations that you could put together. And when you mix and match them, you end up with a lot of keywords. And again, this is a great format to use. For informational topics, you can keep it pretty simple. If you just look for how-to keywords and keyword phrases, you're going to find tons of them out there. So I'm not even going to show you the demo, but I recommend checking out Answer the Public. You can go over to Quora, you can go over to Reddit and find questions that people ask. And depending on the niche and the topic area, there may be a whole lot of forums that are active, and you can just go to forums and see the questions that people ask. By the way, all the research is right there too. So usually you'll be able to find a decent answer, not always, but usually you'll be able to find a decent answer over there in forums if that's where you're doing some keyword research and niche analysis. So you have a couple formats that you can use, and you may find some others that are specific for your niche, but these tend to work really well. Now remember, the KGR is not bulletproof, so you should watch the video coming up next about the pitfalls of the keyword golden ratio. And if you haven't downloaded the free KGR calculator spreadsheet, it makes things so much easier. It's free. You can get the link in the description. And by the way, I'm Doug Cunnington. You could subscribe to the channel for more videos on keyword research and making money online.